You've probably heard about using robotics to help with surgery, but now a first has arrived here in KC. The only robot in a 14-county area that can reduce risk in spine surgery for people with back pain. KCTV5's Betsy Webster got a first-hand look in the operating room at KU Health Systems.
Chuck Scott's garage is more than just storage. It's an homage to his travels.
I have tried to collect a poster representing each of the countries we have visited.
But for the past year, he's had a travel companion he could do without.
Discomfort was a constant companion, and pain was an occasional but unwelcome visitor.
We'll get you back there, I think, around 8 o'clock.
Kimberly Barnhart feels his pain, literally.
I'm tired of being in pain.
She's prepping for back surgery that's getting new guidance from a robot. Nothing as sci-fi as the robots you know.
Danger, Will Robinson.
It's called the Globus Excelsius GPS, providing a precise path for multiple screws. The surgeons map out where they need to drill weeks in advance.
There's the right side screw, here's the L5 screw on the left.
The day of the surgery, the robotic arm positions the trajectory just so, allowing for all the tools to take the same path again and again, rather than finessing manually with each pass. That means making a smaller incision, which is important because getting to bone means cutting through muscle tissue.
The smaller the incision, the less muscle trauma, the less pain they have, the quicker the recovery.
Which means less time on opiates and, dare we say, less chance for error in a location where error can be disastrous.
One of the biggest hurdles in spine surgery is knowing exactly where you are and knowing where the important structures are, meaning the spinal cord and the nerves.
It's a bit like GPS navigation.
Hey, Ted.
But more specifically, like motion capture used in Hollywood. That's the role of the metal balls here. Similar to what's on actors' motion capture suits. Chuck Scott is intrigued by the science, but what really matters is...
I was up and walking around the same day as my surgery. That evening, I got up and walked around without assistance.
Which means his next destination.
Our next trip is to the Holy Land in June of 2020.
Should be even more rewarding than the last.
Travel, to me, is the elixir of life.
Betsy Webster, KCTV5 News.
Medical journals point to a small improvement in accuracy from 94.9% to 97.9%.